So ordinarily, the court should have caught our attention. Come, if you're following me, listen to you. Why, what is going on here? We have more than 8 or 10 officials of SSS inside the court. The AG, DPP was represented, is also in court, with about 7 lawyers there in court also for the federal government.
But sorry, how many in specific that the DSS officer insisted?
Let him land, sir, continue.
How many?
They said they can only allow about 5 persons only. And we have more than 7 or 8 of us here. We have people representing several groups in here, lawyers. Bruce Fenn can be flee all the way from the U.S. Who is the Namdi Kanu's attorney in U.S. and also IPOB attorney. So I've not seen such thing. So the ideal thing for us to do is to go back and re-strategize. Obviously, I don't think we are going to continue with this course. Most likely, we're going to take it off from there. Because the court, by virtue of what transpired today, I don't think we still have implicit confidence in the ability of the court to deliver justice in this case.
If I could just interject, could I apologize here? They say my name is Bruce Fine. I'm Namdi Kanu's international lawyer. I'm from the United States. Today was the 5th time I was told I could not enter the courtroom, despite the court's previous order that Namdi could have access to any 3 persons he wanted to. I actually had a chance to talk briefly to him on the way to the courtroom. It's clear 5 times that they are targeting me as to lawyers in a criminal case. It's enshrined in the Nigerian Constitution. It's enshrined in the International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights. It's enshrined in the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. It's a basic principle of civilization. If you're accused of a crime, you have a right to counsel. And he's been denied access to me 5 times. And I'm here not to be an irritant. There are huge international law issues that are present in Namdi Kanu's case. You all know this kidnapping in Kenya, the extraordinary rendition to Nigeria just being one of them. So I'm here because I'm an international law expert to provide more enlightenment on what legal issues are present here. I'm not here to just try to create a problem or to create some kind of irritation. And yet I've been denied 5 times. What am I a threat about? I have not acted in any way that's disruptive. I've been courteous, provided identity that they've asked for. And every single occasion, Mr. Fine, you can't visit him. It's clear that I am the reason why we were locked out of court today.
Okay, let me interject briefly as a special counsel. We consider what happened today as a clear and flagrant violation of Section 36 of Nigerian Constitution, which is his right to fair hearing. It's very fundamental.